was really hoping that I would have the great news to tell you that I saw these raccoons I've been trying to make friends with right before I went live, but they weren't out there. I will check again afterwards. I got to feed them a banana the other day, and it was excellent. Welcome. We're gonna try and finish Vincent's Secret of Myers tonight. We're gonna give it a second to see if there's any stragglers. I really enjoyed this visual novel. I'm a little sad that it's on indefinite hiatus, but when I click over to the game screen, the donation link will be on screen. Feel free to donate to Dino, because I think that that's why development's on hiatus. They also have other games, some of which look really good, and I might play one, though I really think Missed Messages or How We Know We're Alive is going to be next. I'd love to do Pumpkin Panic, but I just don't think that my computer is going to run it and stream it at the same time. What else? Vimic, nice to see you. Hades. Alright. Let us get this road on the show. We're gonna do the thing. Go to dino999z.itch.io if you would like to donate to this creator to try and get more of this game made. Because otherwise we're gonna finish it in chapter 4, and I think that it was supposed to be 6 chapters. So we'll have to just speculate our own endings beyond that point. Here we go. I forget how great the damn score is every time. This one. Okay, so we are in the basement at Myers Corporation. We've run into Vincent. He's being menacing. We're all gonna take a sip of water. Whether or not we have cotton mouth right now. Especially if you do. In the interest of honesty, that was a sip of coffee on my end, but I will also take a sip of water because I do have cotton mouth. I feel like we were in the middle of investigating. Okay, mediocre humans must give up their lives in order to create our utopia. It is a necessary sacrifice. That's what the Myers Corporation thought. I understand now. It is not a flaw that the cyborgs Myers produces need to feed on humans. In fact, it is quite the opposite. That's the intention of the Myers Corporation to begin with. Right, so when we finished last week, Vincent was like, oh, Myers is, they feel like they've created a new species, which doesn't super make sense because it's absolutely, you know, human-based. And I don't know if they can reproduce. Hold on, I'm just double-checking something really quick. Dope. Okay. Just making sure that last week's stream is preserved, because I know that it's not live yet, but I want to make sure that everything was there. Oh, my heater just kicked on. Give me 1 second, I'm going to turn that off. Finally cold enough to turn it on, but I do not need the noise right now. Okay, so yeah, Myers feels like they've created a new species because they've made these cyborgs that eat people. And so, yeah, that's part of the point, because they want to eradicate people. So, like, they are no longer a corporation. They are a terrorist organization? I hesitate to use that word in this instance. I mean, they do release the cyborgs into the populated areas. I don't know. I mean, I guess it's capitalism to its ultimate end, right? Infinite growth isn't really possible. What's the clicker game that demonstrates this? Infinite Paperclip? Jacob Geller has a great video on it. Highly recommend. But yeah, you like consume all the matter on Earth and then you start consuming the universe in order to make more paperclips. Like, it stops being an office supply company at some point because you destroy everything. It stops being the point to make money. So I guess Myers Corporation has infinite paperclipped itself and, or intends to be that, which is just going to reduce the world to gray goo. I don't understand what the end game is here. What do they hope to, what, they want to live surrounded by man-eating cyborgs? It's a weird dream. And also, I would like to finish looking at this room. If the cyborgs are placed at the top of the food chain above humans, there will never be a chance for equality between the two. Correct. Okay. We look at this already? Nothing special about the duct. A poster of Meyer-chan. The poster was firmly fixed to the wall with some kind of white glue around it. I picked at it with my finger, but I couldn't get it off. Okay, I'm starting to remember. Some puzzles. A drawer. It doesn't have anything in it. This is where the mug came from. Can we... Alright. The mug will take us back. Lamp. A Monster M's desk. Or no, I think we turned it on last time. A piece of paper printed with strange rectangles. They are the same color as... The puzzle. Okay, so kind of an irregular square, orange, cyan, red, purple, and then a purple and orange equal sign next to it. Maybe I will remember that. Okay, let's take a look at his computer. Screw it. Catch him. Monster M's laptop. Can I catch Meyer-chan? Oh. Monsieur M. Now, wait a second here. Now, on the right, is this a picture of him? As a bunny boy? Or bunny girl? A bunny person? And him as a maid? This is Monsieur M's OnlyFans. I feel like I'm not really supposed to see these photos. Okay, so Vincent and him have met, and also he's got a thing for Vincent. Looks like this picture's related to that piece of paper in the envelope. Yeah, it is. Shit. Okay, so red. I need a pencil. Because I still kind of remember what the diagram looked like there. It's red, purple, orange, orange again, cyan, and then purple. Let's go check that. But I also want to, is there anything in these files? We cannot interact. Okay. We about to get in trouble for this? No, I totally remembered that. What brain damage? Yeah, let's turn his fucking light off. Fuck him. Does the paper look different without this weird light on it? Interesting, the colors have changed, so that's it. The colors only show up when I turn on the lamp. Well, luckily, I already wrote down what I figured out. Let's go back to this time period. Your device will unlock automatically after entering the correct answer. If a wrong answer is entered, the device will return to zero when it reaches six digits. Okay, and it is red, purple, orange, orange, cyan, purple. Access granted. 'Cause I'm a fucking genius. We need a key? I solved the whole puzzle. Mysterious box, there is a keyhole in it. Alright, and I think I already checked the other. Yeah, there's nothing in these. Gotta check. Okay, and then also. I wanna pick at this with the scalpel. Please. I took out my scalpel and cut off a portion of the solidified glue along the edge of the poster, then tore the entire thing off. What in the fuck is that? It's a painting? It's nice. I kind of like it. Get out of the way. There's another poster hidden underneath Meyer Chan's poster. And the seemingly lovely, innocent Fenora has a secret hidden scalpel. The world sure is full of surprises. Can I look at it more? There is another poster hidden beneath Meyer Chan's poster. Fenora, do you know the name of this work? No, I don't. The Destruction of Leviathan. It is written in the book of Isaiah that when God comes to earth on Judgment Day, he will punish Leviathan and slay him. The Destruction of Leviathan depicts the scene. Leviathan is the great sea serpent. In the upper right corner of the original work, God can be seen in the sky handling a sword with a fierce look. But in this poster, that part has been cut off. We can only vaguely see his lower limbs. Can we? And I guess we see a bright thing in the top right. Good enough. So whoever put the poster up here simply wanted Leviathan to be the center of attention. In the book of Job, Leviathan is portrayed as a vicious creature that is so fierce that anyone who witnesses him will be terrified and overwhelmed. He has teeth so terrible and a mouth so strong that nobody can open with force. His eyes are depicted as the great light of the morning and his heart as an unbreakable block of stone. Sounds like a great guy. Oriana, nice to see you. Welcome back. We're trying to finish this evening, so hope you will stick around. It is worth mentioning that Leviathan is also the name of a well-known work of political philosophy. Yeah, it is. Did you just say that Leviathan is also the name of a philosophical work? Yes, in the book, Leviathan is a symbol of power and a metaphor for the author's ideal commonwealth and perfect government. Okay, that wasn't much of an elaboration there. We've looked at this. We're gonna take a moment before we move on. Okay. So we're referring to Leviathan, or The Matter, Form, and Power of a Commonwealth, Ecclesiastical and Civil, by Thomas Hobbes. It was published in 1651, the Revised Latin edition in 1668. Its name derived from the biblical Leviathan. The work concerns the structure of society and legitimate government, and is regarded as one of the earliest and most influential examples of social construct
contract theory, written during the English Civil War, 1642 to 1651. It argues for a social contract and rule by an absolute sovereign. Hobbes wrote the Civil War and the brute situation of a state of nature, the war of all against all, could be avoided only by a strong, undivided government. I think this is the nasty, brutish, and short guy. So this is like the this painting is a reference to, like, a monarchist. Like a philosophical monarchist. Did we already look at this bookshelf? Filled with books on history and philosophy. Yes, it's the first thing we looked at because that's how I knew Vincent was going to show up. History and philosophy. Philosophy. Na-na! Vincent, you mentioned that Leviathan is also the name of a philosophical work, right? That is correct. I swept my eyes quickly over each of the book's titles. Being in Nothingness, Republic, The Birth of Tragedy. Here it is, Leviathan. Is there a key in it? I took Leviathan off the bookcase and opened the book. As I had expected, the inside of the book is actually completely hollow. Hidden inside is a key. Alright, so we're gonna open that thing. Can we examine this person's computer? Looks like you need to follow the on-screen instructions to enter some form of password. I don't know what the password is yet. I need to gather more clues. Okay. And we can't look in the drawers of that desk. But we can unlock this box because we have the key now. The box is unlocked. What I find inside is... is this Gucci, Penelope, and Boss? Those are the names of my three cats. Victor's eyes and arms. Isn't this a picture of you guys at university? Vincent didn't answer. He looked away to the other side of the room. MU32 2077. Denied. Oh, okay. What? Just let me type it then. RMU37. Excellent. Oh, okay. I thought we were gonna look at this computer. Well done, Venora. Weird that we have a name now. Everybody drink water. My vision blurred as soon as the secret chamber opened. Are we gonna have a flashback just from this door opening? Or it's like our brain shorting out? I mean, I've suspected that we're like a clone slash some sort of cyborg for a while now. Because clearly Vincent's literal blood-related brother slash butler, whose name now I don't know why I can't think of it. We'll see him again. Clearly knew us. Alright, let's just figure it out. What the shit is this? I could no longer see my surroundings, but I could vaguely sense a black shadow appearing in front of me. Do you remember now your mission? This is like Dr. Tomo from Sailor Moon. The eye and mouth silhouettes. She was staring straight at me with a creepy smile on her face. My mission. You know what I mean, don't you? I'm sure you do. That man has to die. What? Are we a Manchurian candidate? She turned around and began to walk slowly, bit by bit, towards the chamber. That man has to die. We have a scalpel. Do we have to kill this man? I just bumped the mic. I apologize. I don't know if I can kill this guy. Like, he's clearly a douchebag, but... Is he trying to kill someone? I watched her step into the chamber until her whole body was swallowed by the darkness. What was that thing? What is it, Venora? Why are you still hesitating? I've got dots in my mouth. Vincent didn't seem to catch that strange sight. Ladies first. His smile still makes me feel uneasy. I didn't say anything more. We're just gonna walk into this dark-ass room. After a few seconds of hesitation, I gathered my courage and walked into the secret chamber. I could feel Vincent following me closely. Those dark green walls and that dim light. The sight in front of me didn't surprise me. The chamber looked exactly like the one I saw earlier in the cyborg's eyeball. Ugh. And all around me were bloodthirsty cyborgs chained to the wall. But at that moment, the only thing that caught my attention was this one cyborg in front of me. He kept lunging at me like a murderous beast, but the limb restraints made it difficult for him to move an inch. The way he looks... Wait a minute, there's no doubt that he is the same cyborg I saw from the memory of that eyeball. No, it's more than that. Everything I'm seeing right now feels so familiar. I very clearly remember the scene that I saw when I picked up that cyborg's eyeball. It's exactly the same as what I'm seeing now. So we can see the future? I don't understand. Was I not seeing the past memories of that cyborg but my own present experience? I thought back to everything I had experienced since coming to the Myers Corporation. I suddenly realized something. Something that I had overlooked this whole time. What is it, Venora? Have you discovered anything new? It was you all along, wasn't it, Vincent? Was it? Vincent wasn't fazed at all. Instead, he had a contemptuous smile on his face. The graffiti outside the Myers Corporation, the invitation letter and the 4-digit code of the employee passageway, the history and philosophy books in the basement. Oh, I figured the books, and that college photo in the box. From the time I arrived at Myers until now, I had always assumed that the experiments here were conducted by the secret underground Myers Corporation themselves. But that doesn't make any sense, does it? Why would the Myers Corporation call themselves murderer and use the same combination as the employee access password? And that party on the same day as your accident? Why would that have been the beginning of the nightmare for the Myers Corporation? Why would the bookcase in the basement here be filled with your favorite books on philosophy and history? And why is that college photo of you and Victor a clue to unlocking the secret chamber? If you think about it, there can only be one explanation. Because this whole time, it wasn't the secret underground Myers Corporation that was still conducting experiments here at the site, but you, Vincent Edgeworth. That makes more sense than the company, because, like, yeah, what would the endgame be? But what's necessarily the endgame for Vincent? Like, does he want to be a man-eating cyborg? He turned his boyfriend part cyborg to be safe? Like, what is happening? I do not get it. An interesting theory. Indeed, it seems that I can't really blame you for thinking that way. If your suspicions are correct, then why would I come here to help you expose myself? It's simple. This is all part of your plan. To do what? In the case of the G4 cyborg incident, you, as the lawyer for the Myers Corporation, pinned all of the blame on Winston Loomis to cover up the fact that the cyborg experiment was planned by the Myers Corporation themselves. And yet, instead of being valued by the Myers Corporation, you're almost killed in their carefully orchestrated car accident. You tried your very best and devoted everything you had to them, but all they did was discard you like a pawn. So, with this grudge against them, you decided to take your revenge on the Myers Corporation. To defeat the Myers Corporation and become the one in control, you needed to master technology even more advanced than theirs. Maybe he personally did Victor's eyes and arms. And become even more frightening than the Myers Corporation. Having come to this conclusion, you decided to rescue Winston from prison and made a deal with him to reassemble the cyborgs that the Myers Corporation had discarded, and together develop a new technology that would strike fear into Myers. That technology is what I have inside me, the ability to see others pass. Not only that, you actually knew very well that the Myers Corporation was conducting similar research, but their progress was very slow. So you made a deal with a member of Myers' secret organization, and had him assist you in stealing all the documents and samples related to the research into this power by the Myers Corporation. Around the same time, you sent Myers a threatening video suggesting that you were developing a secret weapon, which caused them great paranoia. After you obtained everything you needed, you brutally murdered that member and used his corpse as cattle feed for your reconstituted cyborgs. His name was Dr. Richard Emanon. He was tragically found dead in his apartment with his body ripped apart. After that, I was sent to your mansion as a detective to investigate the recent disappearances and the truth behind the G4 cyborg incident. Strangely enough, I can't remember what happened after that. I woke up in your mansion and had lost all my memories. But unexpectedly, I gained the power to see others' past, other people's past, which I didn't possess before. But the clues I discovered at the Myers Corporation told me, on the night that I came to your mansion, in fact, you and I visited this building, the old Myers Corporation, together as a pair. I haven't yet figured out what really happened that night, but what I do know is, you're the culprit behind the disappearances that have happened in the G4 district over the past few years. You've been secretly reassembling cyborgs here with Winston. You need cattle feed to keep them alive. And me? I was used by you as a guinea pig to test this new power you created, the power to see other people's memories. And somehow you erased my memory to see if I could utilize my new power to find clues about my past. You set up the old Myers Corporation building as a testing ground for me and designed all sorts of puzzles, then lied to me about finding a Myers Corporation business card in my pocket when I woke up in your mansion. So, like, this is not just a setup, but, like, a setup upon a setup. This is, like, completely orchestrated. That is so involved. I don't know if I think that this is totally correct, though. And lured me here to begin your experiment. Well, how's that? Is there anything else that I need to explain? Well done, Venora. You're truly impressive. Impressive? In other words, you don't deny anything I have said. Correct. I admit that I am indeed the one behind everything. Are you serious? However, I must comment, there's one fatal error in your near-perfect reasoning. Okay. How do you know that you're really Venora, cyborg lady? That's what I'm saying! Weren't you the one who called me Venora first? True, but have you forgotten? As we discussed before, a person's personality is determined by how much they remember. A person's personality is determined by how much they remember. The reason why I call you Venora is because your demeanor is the same as hers. In other words, I know you have recovered the memory of Venora's and think you are her. But if that same memory was given to another cyborg, they too would think they were Venora, wouldn't they? If you're toying with me, I don't believe you. Venora, do you perhaps remember the date of the day you came to my mansion as a detective? Yes, it was December 1st, 2086. And do you know what the date is today? No, I don't. Today is March 5th, 2087. So it's been like 3 months. That's right, you've absolutely no clue what has happened in the last 3 months. The real Venora is long gone. I apologize, Venora. I'm afraid I must end our conversation here. If I have to be honest, I too did not wish to see everything end this way. However, I have no choice but to let you spend the rest of your life here with your kind. Okay. But why? Why are you doing this? If I'm not the real Venora, why are you doing this to me? What did I do to you? Venora or not, your heart belongs to the Myers Corporation. Your body reeks of decay, and your soul embodies putrid corruption. She is yours now, my friends. Wait, wait. Oh, are we, like, diving into his brain? Ooh, that makes me want to play Remember Me. I need a PlayStation, man. I can stream directly from it. Amidst the chaos, I subconsciously reached out with my right hand and grabbed the closest, most accessible thing to me. Vincent's tie. I don't remember why I did that. What I do remember is when I grabbed his tie, my vision started to blur again. The last thing I saw was a hint of panic on Vincent's face. Hello. Investigation completed. Successfully located the secret chamber. I'll say, we've been in there for several minutes. Vincent Edgeworth, is it? Here's your package. Have a nice day. Thank you very much. I just don't understand why he's wearing a tuxedo at college. Oh, hey, Vincent. There you are. I was wondering why I hadn't seen you in the library. What's wrong, Vincent? You look a little down. Let me guess. Did that international kid from G2 piss you off again? No. Then what's the matter? Did something happen? I was hired by the Myers Corporation. I received my job offer letter from them today. Oh, what did you just say? That's wonderful news, Vincent. Congratulations. I did the wrong voice. Whatever. I've made it this far mostly just reading them. I have to practice more. That's wonderful news, Vincent. Congratulations, we should celebrate. Uh-huh. Vincent, hasn't it been your lifelong dream to work for the Myers Corporation? Why are you looking so glum? Yes, it is indeed my dream to work at the Myers Corporation. It's just, it also means that everything at RMU is about to end. I never thought I would feel such deep sorrow about leaving here. My 4 years here have just flown by. You've worn the same tux the entire 4 years. Yeah, it's all coming to an end, isn't it? I still vividly remember the first day we met. I can't believe that was 4 years ago. Speaking of which, the class will be having a graduation party tonight. Would you like to come with me, Vincent? He's asking him out? Not interested. I'm not surprised at all. You know, Vincent, they are all your friends. There's nothing wrong with seeing them one last time, wouldn't you agree? They are not my friends. Maybe you don't feel that way, but they do. They see you as their friend. I don't want to be friends with them. Just having you is enough. Oh my god, speak! Then how about just the two of us? Just you and me, there will be nobody else. You're almost out of university. You've never had a drink, have you? My favorite bar is downtown G4. Let me take you there like a date. What do you think? Oh my god, they're asking each other out. When? How about 5 o'clock tonight? I'll drive us there. Of course, that also means I won't be able to drink tonight. It's a deal, then. Oh, he's gonna play Sober Sister for him on their date. That is the sweetest thing I've ever heard in my life. This is very wholesome for them to end up supervillains later on. Are you ready, Vincent? Huh? Wait a second. Did you use hair gel on your head? What? And if you've never seen hair gel, and he doesn't look any different, I don't think. What? No. Not only that, but you've also changed into a new suit. How can you tell? It just looks like the same tuxedo. Did you really think this was a date, Vincent? Don't do that. This was so sweet! You have some nerve to say that. Do you really think I can't smell the cologne you're wearing? Okay, you got me there. Okay, good. They're just playing. Sometimes I have trouble telling these things. Anyway, shall we get going then? Do we get to see them at the bar? This man wore a tux for all of college and then wears a regular suit once he gets a job. I've just realized. Did you know an estimated 50 to 80% of life on Earth is located under the surface of the oceans? The oceans contain 99% of the living space on the planet, and humans only have explored less than 10% of that space. Not only that, but the oceans account for 96% of all the water on the surface of the Earth, and the remainder? It's all fresh water in the form of rivers, lakes, and ice. At the same time, the ocean absorbs about 25% of the CO2 emitted into the atmosphere from human activities each year. This greatly reduces the impact of greenhouse gas on the climate. The ocean sure is incredible and full of wonder, wouldn't you say, Vincent? Vincent's talking to Vincent. Oh my god, you sound just like him. I heard that guy is getting a PhD after he graduates. After that, oh okay, he was doing an impression of someone. After that, he's going back to G2 to take over his father's company. Oh really? I have absolutely zero interest in knowing his future career plans. Bartender, please make me another martini. See? I knew you would enjoy martinis. Then what about you, Victor? What are your plans after graduation? Like you, I've been hired by a company. I will be working at their investment department. That's wonderful news to hear, Victor. I'm happy for you. Really? You don't look so happy to me. No, no. Believe me, I really am. It's just that I was thinking. These may be the final days we get to sit side by side like this. So would you like to sit closer than side by side? Before we're not in college anymore? You guys look so sad. You're going to move in together in a big mansion and one of you is going to pretend to be the bartender? Guess you're getting too attached to me, huh? Does going into the Myers Corporation alone make you nervous? Sometimes it really feels like you're reading my mind. Because you're soulmates. Huh, what's this? Oh my god. That's why he stopped wearing that stupid tux. A graduation present from me. Since you're going to be working at the Myers Corporation, I thought you would maybe consider changing your outfit. A black tie gives a more professional feel, don't you think? Yeah, you don't look like a piano player at a hotel bar. Thank you, Victor. I will treasure it. Hopefully you'll wear it. We learn that he does, of course. Listen, my friend, what I'm going to say next may sound a little cheesy, but these are all words that come from the bottom of my heart. Do you remember the day we first met each other in our dorm? How could I ever forget? To tell the truth, I never thought we would become best friends when I met you that day. I know, I did say to you that I was sure we would become great friends. However, I didn't really mean it at that time. But you've changed me so much in the last 4 years because you don't even realize it. Wait. Okay, I don't know why I saw because when it says perhaps. But you've changed me so much in the last 4 years, perhaps you don't even realize it yourself. Every second I'm with you, I feel like my life is full of meaning. You've helped me regain my purpose. I want to be an outstanding person like you, Vincent. But more importantly, I want to stay with you and keep being there for you. I'm sure that you'll achieve so many great things when you enter the Myers Corporation, because I know you, and I know there's nothing Vincent Edgeworth can't possibly do. But I also can't deny that your journey at the Myers Corporation will always be smooth. You're going to face all kinds of challenges and inevitably setbacks, some big, some small. But I want you to know that whenever you feel overwhelmed and need a hand, whenever you need someone to reflect on the ups and downs of life with. He's gonna ask him to marry him. I feel like he's asking him to marry him. You'll have a dear friend, always waiting for you at the investment department at the Myers Corporation. Could this be? My job offer letter from the Myers Corporation. I'm sorry, Vincent Edgeworth. I'm afraid you're not getting rid of me yet. Vincent? Oh my god, they're in the dark. Are you crying? Nothing is predestined in life. I've always believed that ever since I was a child, a person's destiny can be changed by no one but themselves. But at that moment, I finally realized I was wrong. So terribly wrong. The day we met at RMU, the moment he entered my life, everything was destined to change. Coming to RMU was my fate. Meeting him was my fate. Getting to know him was my fate. I just remembered that there is a pet store near the bar. Want to go see some kittens. This is the cutest fucking date. But just as one person is enough to transform your life, a corporation full of sin is also enough to take everything away from you. Vincent, the company is in big trouble. You have to make them believe that it's all his fault, or this might be over for us. My name is Vincent Ashworth. I am a former attorney at the Myers Corporation. To many people, an attorney stands for law and justice, yet my life is filled with nothing but sin. I do whatever it takes to achieve my aims. Forged evidence, bribery, everything. Sounds selfish, doesn't it? But it was all for the best of my company, my one and only dream company. I've never lost a single case I've taken on, even this one. Yet the company paid me back by trying to kill me in a car accident. Okay, it's him groaning from being in the accident. Pain. Every single bone in my body was crushed. Crimson blood filled my vision. But somehow I survived. The next thing I remember, I was laying on a piece of cold metal. My body couldn't move, but I could faintly hear voices around me. Remove the organs. Begin implanting the endoskeleton. Of course he's also a cyborg. So, now, some things have occurred to me. So, yeah, of course Vincent's also a cyborg because he was in that car accident. But, also, that means that potentially he wants to live on a planet of cyborgs because he feels like he'll be safe because he's also a cyborg. And we did see him standing in that room with the cannibalistic cyborgs and they didn't attack him. But wouldn't that mean that we're safe from the cannibalistic cyborgs as a cyborg ourselves? Does that not add up? I think that adds up. I wanted to struggle, I wanted to scream, but all I could do was watch it happen. After hours of operation, I was placed inside the secret chamber. Countless tubes penetrated my torso. Standing in front of me were the core members of the Myers Corporation. No, there was another figure, a figure that seemed so familiar, but at the same time different. Mr. Myers? Feed him. A piece of raw meat was thrown in front of me. Human flesh. Oh, Vincent is a cannibalistic cyborg. They can be. So then why are the other ones not, more, like, they don't have personalities? He's just not good at it, so he makes shitty ones. I felt disgusted, but I couldn't help but engulf it. Leave him in the chamber and observe his behavior. Yes, Monsieur M. Wait, don't go. Tell me, why? Why are you doing this? I did everything you asked. I devoted everything I had to this company. I know, Vincent. I know. I've seen all your efforts. And that's why I know you would be willing to take this little pain for the company too, wouldn't you? No. Goodbye, Vincent Ashworth. I hope you survive. No. I don't remember how long I was kept there. Every day, every second in the chamber felt so long. Revolting chunks of flesh, torn skin, and the unbearable pain. I felt that living was worse than death. I just wanted everything to be over. Ugh. Oh, we have, like, a robot hand. My black tie. It had long been stained crimson with blood. So we're just a robot skeleton now. We still have the memories of ourselves as Vincent. But we're just a robot skeleton and we're still wearing the suit? Or are we just a skeleton with a tie on? Was the tie on the ground of the secret chamber? I would like details. Victor, I wonder how that guy is doing now. What would he think if he sees the monster I've become? Is this all part of my fate? To join the Myers Corporation alongside him, but then never be able to see him again? I'm the naive one after all. This entire time I was just another one of Myers' pawns. I was never truly accepted by them. Huh? You're asking me if a person's fate could possibly be changed? If I have to be honest, I can't give you an exact answer either. Hey, he's wearing Vincent's old bow tie. Maybe. But what I do know is, if that man is Vincent Ashworth, then he will never let anyone dictate his destiny. No, destiny or not, this isn't the ending I wanted. They can crush every bone in my body and slice off every inch of my skin. But I, Vincent Ashworth, cannot accept spending the rest of my life here in this rotting, reeking chamber. If he doesn't have any flesh left, and he's been eating human flesh, do you think that he ate himself? That would be so cool. And really weird. Stream Farmer, nice to see you. They fed him his own body. I have so much more to achieve, and I have so many things that I want to see again. Even if I am no longer human, even if it's no longer possible for me to return to a normal life, as long as I have one last gasp, I will claw my way back through hell. Rawr! No, that's not enough. I will make every core member get what they deserve. Okay, this comes more into focus. But I don't understand killing the world. I will let them know what it feels like to have their bodies torn apart. I will make Myers Corporation pay a painful price. Everybody drink water. You saw all of that. It was you. You were the one who murdered all the core members. What exactly are you? That's really pretty to look at. Me? What am I? Can't you tell? Okay. I'm a product of the Myers Corporation, just like you. Take a good look. This is how Myers Corporation treats a lawyer who's done everything he could for them. I know Myers isn't done yet, but soon I will clean them all up. I let go of Vincent's tie and ran out of the chamber at lightning speed. Is that the ghost of ourself? Outside the chamber, I once again saw that mysterious figure. She was standing next to the box, seemingly hinting at something to me. I took the photo out from the box and placed it in my pocket, then quickly ran to the next room. Okay. Vincent's roaring. Venora. Draco is his brother slash butler. Draco, is that you? Venora, Vincent is going to berserk. You need to get out of there now. What do I do? You need to first restore power to this room by operating the two control panels connected to the breaker box. This will reactivate the 8 touch monitors on the wall. After that, match all the corresponding symbols on the screens, and the entrance to the next room will unlock. I have locked the door behind you, but I can only hold him off for so long. Please hurry. Oh my god. We're gonna save. Right now. Venora, you need to first restore power to this room by okay. Yeah. I didn't realize that was the speaker. I didn't mean to ask you to repeat it. Okay, there's no extra. What? 9 to 5. I don't understand how we do this. That would be 53. Or 4 plus 57 is 61. We don't have that. Okay. 13. We could 9 moves to make it to 57. And we only have odd numbers. Okay, 57. It's gotta be exact. Excellent job, Venora. Just one more to go. It has to be exactly 9 moves. So we can go down by 7s. Or up by 7s. Or alternate. Damn. Okay. We're gonna have to do just 7s. 53. It can't just be 7s. 1, 9 and the rest 7s? Boom. Okay. We're gonna match some symbols. Perfect. Now all I have to do is match all the corresponding symbols. Okay, miss. I'll watch Meyer-chan. That thing, Meyer-chan again. A cyborg, that thing. Watch and some cyborgs. Let's go. Good work, Venora. Now all there's left to do. There's nobody here but us chickens. You looked a little ripped, bud. Have you been, like, you know, doing some substances? Because I feel like you need to go lay down. Venora, did you really think that you could get away? Oh, God. Ha 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 ha. Yeah, you're tweaking, bud. He's laughing a lot. Oh, and he's twitching. Why is he making squelchy noises when he walks? His shoes are sticky. He's got wires coming out of him. He looks like Jigsaw. What's it, Billy the Puppet? He looks like Billy the Puppet right now with wires coming out the back. Judgment Day for the Myers Corporation is falling upon us. Do I have to fight this guy? Oh my God. Okay. Warning, from here on, you'll need to answer a series of questions, play mini games, and solve puzzles to escape from Vincent. You will only be able to make 2 mistakes. Making more than 2 mistakes or exceeding the time limit will immediately lead to death. Okay. Let's save again. Saving would be a great idea now. Great minds. Question 1. We have this. Venora, here you are, standing face to face with me at this moment. Do you think it is fate for us to be here? Do you believe in fate? What? There's nothing you can change. It doesn't even say this way. Your fate and actions are intertwined. Okay. Nothing in this world is purely a coincidence or the outcome of what we do. This moment as I stand here confronting you is a result of our intertwining fates and actions. Vincent, I saw your past. I know you spent all your youth chasing your dream. Getting into the Myers Corporation was your dream come true. It was not fate that you got into the Myers Corporation. It was because you worked hard for it. However, there are also things that you just can't change. After all, it was your fate to become an outcast and be forced to leave the Myers Corporation because you didn't belong there. What? That doesn't... You're gonna piss him off. How did you... A look of shock appeared on Vincent's face, but then it changed to one of excruciating pain. I ran to the exit of the room. Okay. Just say something rude and book it. Benora. Oh, hello. Tap the space bar and hit the red target. What? Okay. What? Okay, can we try that again? I want to do it again. I want to get it right. Okay, and we'll save after the correct answer. We're going to click through quickly until we get to the question. Yeah. Fates and actions. He gets upset. When we get to the red text, I'm going to save. Okay. Save here. Okay. Do it. Do it. Oh, okay. It's like a stopping it on the thing. Got you. Can we close the door? Thank you. Let's save again. Okay. I'm not safe here, but this door should be enough to hold Vincent off for a while. I'm actually going to... I need to solve the puzzles here. Get out of this room as soon as possible. We are going to take... the briefest of bio breaks. Because I want to finish this. I'm not feeling tired. I have this coffee here. Take a sip. Everybody drink water, which I'm going to do as soon as I'm done drinking this coffee. Wanna run to the potty? You listen to this delicious music, and then we're gonna finish this chapter because I am engrossed, as I hope you are. Darlings, I get the keyboard close to me here in case we have another spacebar QTE. I have to say that for a visual novel, there's QTEs, there are, like, investigation, kind of hidden object puzzle sequences, I'm deeply impressed. Let's, back over here. Let me check chat. Everybody seems to be copacetic. Let's get on with it. I need to solve the puzzles here and get out of this room as soon as possible. Oh my god, okay. Is there a time limit? I don't see a time limit. Project name ICIJ. Classification confidential. Myers Corporation's cutting edge technology has constantly been misinterpreted by many in the world. And this misalignment is bound to bring resistance to the Myers Corporation's cyborg regeneration program. In order to ensure the implementation of the plan without any deviations, we must make the necessary sacrifices to ensure its eventual success. The Myers Corporation will primarily focus on the training of specially selected employees to strengthen their abilities. The main purpose of the program is to purge any possible threats to the development of the Myers Corporation, regardless of any means or cost. Member, Chaser. This member is highly efficient, decisive, and rarely makes mistakes. Their lethal power and quick reactions undoubtedly makes them the top ranking of the task force for eliminating any threats to the Myers Corporation. Rating 9 out of 10. 9 is red, and I think it's the first red thing that I've seen. Cross out the previous thing. So we've got 9. Member Infiltrator. This member is good at blending into crowds and remaining undetected, allowing them to easily sneak into various different situations. The downside is that their work ethic could really be improved as they are extremely reluctant to do any actual work. Rating 7 out of 10. 9, 7. Member Janitor. This member has incredible speed and can freely move inside and outside the corporation grounds. Has an inexplicable obsession with garbage and tasks themselves with keeping all the grounds and equipment sanitary. 10 out of 10. Member Inspector. This member has an uncanny ability to observe and reason, typically noticing many details that were glossed over by others. Additionally, they are an incredible liar and can easily mask their true emotions. 8 out of 10. I wonder if that's us. Alright, so we've got a 5-digit code here. Moving on. We've got some symbols. We need a 4-digit code for that. This note. To all ICIJ members, in order to enhance security of the Myers Corporation, starting today, the code for the input panel of the power supply systems to this room will be changed periodically. Also at the same time, we will randomly select 4 members for assessment. The code for the power supply system will reflect the assessment level of the members during that period from the highest to the lowest. Inspector, Chaser, something and Janitor. Please pass the information on to everyone. So it's not a 5-digit code. Okay. I don't understand what the symbols are, though. Chaser. Is the second highest. We're gonna just find out how the symbols are related to them, I guess. Infiltrator is the one I couldn't remember. Infiltrator is the lowest. Janitor is the highest. And that means Inspector is the third one. JCII. Okay. JCII. If it's like on a phone, then it's A B C D E F G H I J A B C D E F G H I I. Not correct. We have to find out how those symbols are connected. Universal store power to the room. Okay. Based on the lockers. A teddy bear. Okay. Some bullets. Some kind of high-tech wristband. A flashlight. So this key thing is the inspector, because that's us, clearly. So we know that one for sure. A variety of professional uniforms. That's the infiltrator, I guess. A Rubik's Cube that's been taken apart. A bucket for cleaning is the janitor. So that's the chicken foot. So Chaser, what's Chaser's traits? Yeah. Highly efficient, decisive, rarely makes mistakes, lethal power, quick reactions. So bullets? Okay, oh my god. I wish it was easier to just... Oops. I'm gonna say the one with the bullets. Is that you? Yeah. And that's the weird... tree. Okay. Let's click over. See if this is correct. This should be... chicken foot. Weird tree. Key. And the table. Excellent. Okay. That was easy enough. Oh my god, he's right behind us all the time. It's always right as we finish the puzzle. My dude, you need some Visine. You're not just tweaking, you've been like injecting amphetamines into your eyeballs. You are bleeding. The unbearable torture of my body being crushed. The agonizing pain of my blood being drained. I remember everything, Venora. I remember it all. You would be deeply traumatized by that. I definitely understand. And I will never forgive the Myers Corporation. He's gonna get taller. I will slaughter them all. Each and every one of them. Okay, question two. Let's save. As long as I'm still alive, as long as I still have my last breath, I will search every corner of the G4 district, track down every remaining Myers scum, tear off every inch of their skin, and grind their bodies into a fine dust. Deceit, betrayal, 6 long years of waiting. I will have my revenge. Venora, are you prepared for your judgment? You will still be a monster? You're no different from Myers. We're gonna say you still be a monster. Woo! Okay, Yeah, I suppose that's true. If he only killed the people who killed him, that would be a little less morally reprehensible, I think. Mark Zink, welcome to the stream. Oh, murdering the entire Myers Corporation, you say? To be honest, I don't really care. Even if that's your plan, I'm not going out of my way to stop you. But Vincent, you need to realize, there's one thing that you cannot change. Whether the Myers Corporation exists or not, you are and will always be a monster, rejected by society with no future. Jesus! Why is our tactic just to be as mean as fucking possible to the killer robot? Who eats human flesh? For fuck's sake. Oh, I know what you're thinking. No, I still have Victor. I am not alone. But Vincent, Victor is not like you. He's just a human. Sooner or later, you'll lose him. And then you will have nothing left in this world. What the fuck is wrong with her? What did you say? Vincent's expression was filled with even more sorrow. A steady stream of blood flowed from his eye socket. Oh my god. Why are we acting like this? I guess it's effective. He's crying blood. Here he comes. Damn. Nope, we're gonna do it again. I want a perfect pursuit if possible. Don't go for the first one. We go for the second. Oh my god. Okay, I need a fresh piece of paper. Alright, keep pushing, Benora. You're almost there. Soon I'll be able to escape. There's so many numbers on the wall. July 23rd, 2081. Sunny. I never thought that Victor would actually agree to my request. Although he's always the first person to help me with my troubles, no matter what I've asked of him, my request this time is just unprecedented. In order to accomplish it, Victor would have to make a huge sacrifice. I must admit that I feel very guilty and simultaneously worried, because I'm not sure how seriously this will affect him, but I have no choice. Victor is the only person I can trust. This role has to be filled by no one but him. May 7th, 2084. Rain. The carrier has been cultured in the containment unit, and the memories have been successfully implanted into the memory core. Victor did have one request. He wanted all memories to take place before that thing happened. Victor was a consensual guinea pig for this project. Although the carrier won't actually remember those, I could understand why Victor would want that. I complied. May 15th, 2084. Cloudy. No, this isn't even possible. Everything was going so well, but his eyes. I couldn't believe it. They looked exactly the same. Unlike the text before, the last line of the diary looks like it was hastily written with a trembling hand. Okay. Oh, well, I can just write this down if we're just adding it, right? So it's what? 316 785 17 11 4. Might not be the proper way, but just in case it is, I'm writing it down now. Okay. I'm not sure what to do with that. And there's no note. Five of those are written on the wall, which are 8, 17, 3, 11, and 5. And is there anything else? This is after the power's on? Okay. So, we want 3, 8, 5, 17, and 11. I'm so fucking smart, y'all. It wasn't a hard puzzle, but still. Okay. A watch plus a watch equals a watch. An eye, a DNA, and a person? Tuxedo. A target. Monster M. A cigarette. Something, a martini, a glove, and a watch. What the hell does that mean? It's gonna be the red text. Okay. Give me the first piece of red text. This role has to be filled by no one but him. Memories before that thing happened. And his eyes look exactly the same. Get like a failure text. Something plus DNA equals a person. I could definitely do like trial and error martinis. And that suit. His eyes look exactly the same. Only he can fill this role. Only he can fill this role. He only wants members. Memories from before the thing happened. And his eyes look exactly the same. I don't... Chat? Oh yeah, I can just scroll. I don't need to be clicking on it over and over. Victor is going to have to make a huge sacrifice. This role has to be filled by no one but him. Carrier has been cultured. If you have any suggestions. Memories take place before that thing happened. What is that thing? And the eyes looked exactly how they did before. Thoughts? We're missing something. Okay. So we just need... You are... I think this is the eyes. So, like, seeing the past? So, I want a hint. I just want to know who... Well, let's think about the four people we were told about, right? Because there's four people that we really know about. So it's... Janitor, Chaser, Inspector, and Infiltrator. We're the Inspector. The violence... Chaser must be Vincent. Infiltrator doesn't want to do any work... So that's Victor, and that makes Janitor Draco. Draco is an operative. For the Myers Corporation, then? I feel like because I didn't play this chapter all at once that, like, I don't have all the pieces. And, like, what about Zalmona? Is she one of these people? She never doesn't want to do any work. She could be the Infiltrator. And then, like, we met the janitor. So I think that we're trying to figure out what the pieces of a certain cyborg are. How it was created. It's someone's DNA and something else makes the cyborg. So the options for DNA are Monster M. I think Victor smokes. I don't know who that is. That's Vincent. Vincent loves martinis. That's us. And that's the watch is like the original employee. Or is this Vincent? You know what? I think that the suit is Draco because he's a butler. Who is the target. Someone's a target. And then back to Monster M. Victor is the subject. But he said he wants the memories to be all from before the thing happened. And we don't know what the thing is. This... So whose brain and whose body? One of these is Victor. Damn it, I did it again. And he's... Maybe he's not his brother. Maybe he's his clone. Oh, I'm a fucking genius. Let's run. Oh my god, let's save. He's coming apart, man. Hold it together, Venora. Vincent, you really are quite persistent. Take a look at yourself and what you've become. Are you really that obsessed with killing me? Venora, is running away the only thing you can manage? Me? Running away? Vincent, why can't you see it? You're the one who has really been running away all this time. I don't understand why her thing is like go-to psychological warfare. First she makes him upset, she makes him feel like shit and like really lonely and depressed, which he's already trying to kill her, and it's fallen apart, and now she's just like trying to psychoanalyze him in the middle of this fight. Everybody drink water for my frustration. And a sip of coffee. Okay. Oh my god. Okay, question 3. Ask yourself this, Vincent. Do you really think this is all Myers' fault? Are we asking him a question? You constantly tell yourself that Myers is the cause of all your misfortunes, but the truth is, you just don't want to face the fact that it's obvious to you. You can't change what has already happened, you didn't matter. Aw, shit. No. So it's not you didn't matter. It's the very end of the game and I figured that button out. Okay. So it's you can't change what's already happened? Okay. Dang. Face it, Vincent. You're just using your revenge to distract yourself from something you can't accept. Because in your heart, you don't want to admit what happened in the past can no longer be changed. Perjury, bribery, you committed countless crimes as a lawyer, but you did not do those because you wanted to. Yes, Myers Corporation was the dream company you worked so hard to get into. Of course you would do anything for them. That's what you tell yourself, isn't it? But the truth is, you just wanted to fit in. You just wanted to be accepted by Myers. Ever since your childhood, you've always been a kid who was excluded by others. Despite that, you never tried to hide who you really were until you entered the Myers Corporation. You started to put on a fake smile. You started to imitate others just because you wanted to be accepted by them. But just when you thought everything was going so smoothly, all of that happened. Only then did you realize how foolish you had been. You wanted to go back in time. You wanted to go back to RMU and start over again. I think we're pissing him off and we're gonna have to run again, so we're gonna save. I pulled the picture of Vincent and Victor together at university out of my pocket. Oh, you're upsetting him further! That is... Vincent stretched out his non-existent right hand to reach for the picture. It's only when you're with Victor that you take your mask off and show who you really are. You always seem so impatient with him, but that's the real you. Everything was ordinary then, but it was the happiest time of your life. You miss that time. But sadly, Vincent, I tore the photo into pieces. You can never go back in time. You can't change what has already happened. this is... We're taking a moment. We're taking a moment. And I'm muting the music for you, but not for me. You cannot go back and change your past. But this is vicious psychological warfare in the midst of a fight. It is important to remember that just because you've done something wrong doesn't mean that you can't do better moving forward. You might not be able to fix what you've done, but every moment is an opportunity to do better than you did the moment before that. That's all that I'm saying. So don't take this too much to heart. Oh. I clicked out by mistake. No, no. We did it. We're safe. Vincent wanted to charge at me, but as he tried to do so, his crumbling body made him collapse to the ground. I wonder if he's gonna be okay, but probably not. Well, Vincent? I walked up to Vincent, who was lying on the ground and unable to move. Since your wish is simply unattainable, could you do me a favor, then? Oh my god, did we just kill him? I lifted my right foot and stomped it into Vincent's face. Oh god, I'm yawning because I'm irritated. Please give up your futile efforts and disappear from this world. I'm almost horrified by this. I lifted my bloodstained foot and stomped his face again. You've already caused so much trouble for the Myers Corporation. If you could do us this one small favor, we'd greatly appreciate it. What? Where's this we and us coming from, Venora? Like, I don't understand your loyalty to this company. I understand not being terribly pleased with Vincent, but I don't understand why you're like, woohoo, my corporate overlords, I will stomp a dying man in the face. Oh my god. Again and again and again, I felt the same emotion swelling up inside me as when I sliced open the cyborg's chest. It felt exhilarating. Before I realized it, the part above Vincent's neck was completely flattened. Finally. Now all there's left to do is finish my mission. If that was a cyborg, I think we learned in a previous episode that the original person can still be alive. Oh, yeah, we did, because Victor is still alive, and Vincent is around, presumably, but Draco exists. Oh my god, Draco's their son. Oh, he's their, like, gay martini son. Now all there's left to do is finish my mission. Telling you this, the ghost of ourself. I started to walk towards the exit. Playing as a cop, I am unsurprised and yet somehow still disappointed. As expected, I met that man again outside the room. Venora, I'm so glad you're okay. How is my master doing? Dead. What? Draco couldn't believe what he was hearing. His whole body began to tremble. I killed him, I nonchalantly added. Venora? But why? Why did you do that? What's the matter? Was Vincent that important to you? My voice was toneless as I questioned him. Do you even need to ask that? He's my master. No, more importantly, he's my brother. After a few seconds of silence, I walked over to Draco. Venora, what are you? I leaned on Draco, wrapped my arms around his waist, and hugged him tightly. I buried my head in his chest. I'm so sorry, Draco. I had no choice. I didn't want to kill him either. But I know you will forgive me, right? I eagerly looked up at Draco, because Inspector is a great liar. We're the villain! We're the fucking villain. Because to you, I'm more important than Vincent, isn't that right? But... I raised my left hand and gently touched Draco's cheek with the tips of my fingers. I could feel his face heating up. Draco, let it just be you and me, just the two of us. We don't need Vincent. Let us both escape from here and live together forever. Venora. He just said her name a lot. After a moment of hesitation, Draco slowly raised his arms and wrapped them around me. I knew it. I hate this bitch. Draco's screaming. I took out the scalpel I had been hiding in my pocket and thrust it deep into Draco's chest. Again and again and again. Found it. From Draco's shredded chest, I pulled out a round spherical device. Are those the memories? Unbelievable. So Vincent's so-called secret weapon is a cyborg made from his own genes and young Victor's memories. Honestly, now that I think about it, you and Victor are indeed alike. Whenever you become too obsessed with someone, you lose all your rationality. Forgive me, Draco. I do appreciate all the help you've provided. However, my mission is to destroy you. I tossed Draco's memory core aside and began to slowly approach him with my scalpel. Oh my god. I deserve this? Why does he deserve this? This is all my fault. I'm sorry, Venora. I'm sorry I couldn't save you. Goodbye, Draco. Oh my god. After that, I took the elevator from the other end of the basement back to the lobby of the Myers Corporation alone. What about the other branch about Victor? When I walked out of the Myers Corporation, I realized it was already the next morning. A man in a blue greeted me at the gate as if he had been expecting me. Oh, Inspector. I knew we were her. It's been a while. Come back to the underground Myers Corporation. What is it, Inspector? What's upsetting you? What are all these tears about? Okay. So, I liked it, but it said that we could do the other branch. I guess I should have done a separate save for that, but... Or that's in what hasn't been released. Okay. We have completed Vincent the Secret of Myers as it currently exists. Please go on itch, download it, play it yourself, see if you can get the Victor branch to open up, though I suspect that that's very much in the unreleased and probably going to continue to be unreleased future chapters. Let Dino know how much you like the shit. I love the shit. And this will be up on YouTube. I know last week's is not up, but I do have it. I checked it at the beginning of the stream. And then they'll have the full playlist together and up. I really would like to do missed messages next, but we might do How We Know We're Alive. I started it just to kind of get a feel for it, and it looks really incredible. Might do a daytime stream over the weekend. We'll see. That might be nice if I have something kind of one shot. Thank you for joining me. Let's see if we get like any Oh, do we get a... In other words, by taking advantage of Venora and Vincent's past memories, Monsieur M wants to turn them against each other. Oh my god. Did I fall for a fake ending? I would be so happy if there's more game. Don't you see, Monsieur M is expecting that woman to come back to the Myers Corporation by making use of her special power. He wants to make her misunderstand her very own past. Let's just say in the absence of all your memories, if all you see of your own past are heinous crimes, you will definitely think that you were just a wicked person as well. In that case, we must interfere with Monsieur M's plan and stop her from investigating the Myers Corporation. She needs to remember who she truly was before falling into Monsieur M's trap. My dear infiltrator. Infiltrator is either Zalmona or Victor. Did you really think everything was going to be so effortless? What you don't know is, her power isn't as simple as seeing the past. She can also see possibilities of the future. What did you just say? Oh my god. Please let me take the other branch right now. I'm about to be so excited. I don't care if I'm up until midnight. We're gonna finish this game. Lady Spriggan. Lady Spriggan, with all due respect, napping here is not the most sensible choice. Oh. My. God. Chapter 4, the end. Oh, why wouldn't you let me choose the other branch? Okay. Yeah, let's just load chapter 3. And we're gonna try and like skim through quickly until we get to the choice. Bullet. Spofo, nice to see you. Drapsnat, I don't know if I said hello earlier. Okay. Now that we know, let's just... Wow. Okay. Good to know. Can I just choose a different path? Did I choose it in chapter 2? How much of this am I gonna have to do? Draco Ashworth. Yeah, let's do the skips. Okay, so we just need to redo this puzzle. Which is the one that's the... That's an extra circle. Okay. A gate. Oh, okay. Yeah, let's go. I just want to know if you'll let me choose the other one now that I've gone through Vincent's shit. Okay, so the circle is red. I know. Okay, so you want me to look at other stuff first. Got it. This is that shape. Drawer's locked. Oh, okay. I don't have enough clues yet. toss around spherical object. None of the rest of them have anything. Yellow diamond, red circle. I don't see a triangle anywhere. There's just not a lot else to look at here. And even if I look up the answer, oh, okay. So I think the problem is that I just haven't played the previous chapter. I don't really want to. Okay. How much of this can I skip through? No, I'm gonna have to dig through memories. I'm just torturing myself. We're gonna stop doing this. Clearly, the game is unfinished, but it's a great game. I highly recommend it. Please go on itch and download it. It's free. Tip the creator, Dino. There's a link to do that on its itch page. Their itch page. Thank you for joining me. Next week, we're probably going to start Miss Messages, and I hope to be able to stream something over the weekend. Have a good week, and a good night, and be good to each other.